low lying Orion and the high flying Lyin.
Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky.
It's that time of year again when the skies almost yell out, spring is here.
That's because when Orion is low lying and the Lyin is high flying, winter is on its way out. Let's show you. Now, most of you know that the star pattern Orion the Hunter is about the surest sign that winter is here. In fact, if you go outside an early evening during December, Orion will be climbing up the southeastern sky as a celestial announcement of the imminent arrival of winter.
And in January and February, when winter is at its coldest, Orion reaches his highest point in the heavens, due south in early evening, almost bragging to the world that he is the master of the season. But then Orion slowly leaves center stage in early evening, and by the beginning of April is tipped over on his side in the southwest, almost hanging on to the sky for dear life. And it's this placement of Orion in the southwestern sky in early evening that always tells us winter is soon coming to an end.
Yes, and although we're always sad to see Orion's bright stars go, nevertheless, a less bright but much bigger constellation takes its place almost overhead in early evening, announcing that spring is here, the constellation Leo the Lyin. If you go out any April night and early evening, you'll see Orion slowly sinking in the southwest, while Leo is crouched at the very roof of heaven, roaring that his season, spring, is here.
Leo is easy to find. His head and forequarters are marked by a backward question mark, or sickle, with the bright star Regulus marking his heart. The triangle of stars to the east marks his rear.
In ancient times, lions were often associated with royalty, and Leo's brightest star, Regulus, means the little king. Regulus is only about half a degree away from the ecliptic, so you'll often see the moon pass quite close to it. And occasionally, the moon will briefly occult it, hiding it from view.
And the planets occasionally move very close to Regulus. In fact, on July 7th, 1959, an extremely rare event occurred when Regulus was actually occulted by Venus as Venus passed in front of it, an event which won't happen again for several centuries.
Regulus is about 85 light years away, which means that we see it not as it looks now, but how it looked 85 years ago. So if you're 85 years old when you look at Regulus, you actually see the light that left it the year you were born.
And thank heavens that it's that far away, because it's 5 times the diameter of our sun and 160 times brighter. This means that if Regulus were as close to us as our sun, we'd all be crispy critters.
Toasty. And this year we have an extra visitor to the constellation Leo. Do you see that bright star under his body?
How can you miss it? It's super bright.
That is the giant planet Jupiter, and he'll be hanging out with Leo all spring, so be sure to check him out. Okay, we have our skies set up for 10 p.m. any night this week. If you look to the west, you'll just barely see Orion's belt above the treetops and fading into the sunset.
If you have trouble seeing all of Orion, you might have better luck finding his dog. That really bright star to Orion's left is called Sirius, aka the dog star. Sirius is seriously bright and should twinkle all sorts of colors when low in the sky.
Sirius marks the nose of the constellation Canis Major, the big dog. Canis Major, like Orion, is a winter constellation. That means he's heading out for the season too. So don't delay. Look for Sirius this week before it's too late. So get outside just after sunset to see low lying Orion and the high flying Lyin.
Two sure signs that winter's going and spring is here.
Keep looking up.